Yeah, it's my dream come true again for the third time. It's awesome to win day one title after this tough year. After my injury, we changed bike also with 250, back on the 250 again. So yeah, really happy to win day one title and be world champion again. Well, from the start of the season, the goal was fight for the EnduroGP title, also in the E1 title. My pre-season went quite well. I was working so hard with a new bike, changing to 250. But the first race was a little bit, I was a little bit disappointed because I didn't finish in the position that I would like. But from there, I started to put some work. We work hard with the team. We make small changes on the bike, not so quite big. But from there, we just keep growing up till the bad luck moment in Sweden. But now I'm really happy with the 250, how it works, the work with the team. This winter we'll work hard too, so I'm really happy now. Well, after Italy, it was good to have that month of break between Italy and Spain because I knew already what things I had to change to come back at the top or fighting for the top step in the EnduroGP class. I worked it so hard, I trained so hard during that month. We changed more things on the bike. And in EnduroGP of my home GP in Spain, I was fighting for the top step of the EnduroGP podium both days, close to the victory. And that is that point where I said, okay, now we are on a good physical moment, good shape. So let's keep this momentum. And I finished that GP second in EnduroGP both days, but really happy because the feeling on the bike was so good there. So yeah, then we go to Sweden, to Finland, sorry. We take the first victory there, where it was incredible. Be back on the 250 and take the first victory in Finland, where that type of racing is maybe not my favorite type of racing, but was incredible to take the first win of the season in Finland. After winning in Finland, then take the win in first day in Sweden, I feel like I had my moment, you know? I feel like strong, confident, feel that feeling with the bike that gives you that extra, you know, extra motivation. On Sunday in Sweden, I had quite a big crash. I was like pushing like in every test. I was leading the day with quite a good gap, so I was not over my 100%, but it comes. It was a hard, probably the hardest moment of my career because I want to be at the top of the EnduroGP. I immediately, when I crash and stand up, I feel that my elbow was completely out, dislocated. I know that I have my collarbone broken, but I didn't feel it because I had so much pain in my elbow. But that's racing, that's life. Before I never think that you need luck, you need only work and belief, but from the last 2 years, I start to believe that you need some luck too. But it's like this. After that, yeah, it was not a really hard 3 weeks. I make surgery in my collarbone, put my elbow back in the place. Then three weeks, like the hardest weeks of my life. I was working so hard to come back in Slovakia, where it was impossible to race there for the doctors. And we were able to be back in Slovakia. I make a good race. When I walked the tests, I was like, I called my wife and I say, Helga, I think this race is impossible to finish how I am right now. Because walking, and I know that race from before is the hardest race of the year. And I told to her that probably I didn't finish the race. So that moment, I was almost crying walking one enduro test. but I don't know how I take the strength, the power to finish that race, also with a good result in that moment that they have, for sure. And yeah, it was a really difficult weekend, but really positive, because in that difficult moment, you show to yourself that who are you, and how you can manage these things. And I was really proud of me, and also for sure with all the team, because they are pushing me from the start till the end. And before the first race in Portugal, it was like a little bit of, I don't know how to say, difficult moment mentally. You never know, you know, if you make the good job or not, because I was only training, you know, never racing. And yeah, we went to the first race and it was incredible. After these hard moments, come back and win both days is like all the hard work, all the suffering is pays back with that great moment, you know? And it was incredible, because yeah, many people can think it's only a win, first step on the podium, but the work behind the suffering is incredible. So it was a surprise for me also. When you know that you can win a title, in the morning when I woke up, I try to don't think about it. Like, okay, today is a normal day, but it's never a normal day, because there is like something here that tells you, you can be world champion, you can be world champion, but I don't want to think about it. I just want to give my best, be myself on the bike, enjoy and pushing like always. But you have all the day this thing, you know? Winning here in Portugal, the first day, in the first day of racing, the E1 world title was incredible. Was another dream come true for me.
That he finished in the best way for us. Congratulations to Joseph, again world champion, and congratulations to all the team.